You've probably heard people refer to atoms with different numbers next to them, like uranium-234 or carbon-16. These represent isotopes, but what is an isotope?
But before we start, we need to know what's in the atom.
In this example, we'll be using potassium. Potassium has 19 protons, an electron ring of 2, 8, 8, and 1, and a mass of 39.09.
Different isotopes of potassium are found all around us. Right, Kevin?
This is a diagram of a potassium atom. On the outer ends are the electrons, and inside are protons and neutrons. You see, the difference between isotopes are that they can have different numbers of neutrons, and therefore different masses.
Each isotope has different properties because of its different mass. Get it, Kevin? We'll use three different isotopes of potassium as examples.
This is the nucleus of potassium-39, and it is 39 because of its 19 protons and 20 neutrons.
By adding a neutron to the nucleus, we get the completely different and rarer potassium-40. The basic characteristics of the atom do not change, however, because it still has the same amount of protons and electrons. Even with these different qualities, it's still the same atom. But be careful, Meryl. This particular isotope is radioactive.
By adding one more neutron to the mix, you get the extremely rare potassium-41. So in summary, isotopes have different masses and qualities due to their varying numbers of neutrons, but are the same element because of their protons and electrons.